today I want to teach you about integration by parts. So, in this topic, integration by parts, it is used to integrate a product of two functions, which is we have two different functions, so we can use integration by parts. For example, the product of algebraic and transcendental function. This method can evaluate this following integral. Okay, this is example. Example function. So besides, this method also can evaluate many other types of integral. Okay, in this subtopic, we also have the formula. So you need to memorize this formula because it's not going to be in the exam. So you need to memorize by yourself. U dv equal to uv minus integrate v du. So if let's say the function is given between two different functions. And then you need to identify which one is u, which one is dv. So I will teach you more. Okay. So how to choose? How to choose whether use u or v? U or dv? How to choose u or dv in the function by using Lopez. You know what is that?
No.
Don't know. Okay. This is we can choose the function by using Lopez. So first, Lopez is stand for low logarithm. P is polynomials. E exponential. T trigonometry function. And I is inverse trigonometry. So this is the formula integral by parts. That's it. Identify the function given by this arrangement. Okay, so example integrate x sine 2x. So what is u? X or sine 2x? By using Lopez. Lopez P.
Sine 2x.
Okay, x is what? X is?
Polynomial.
And sine 2x is? Trigonometry. Okay, so u is equal to? Polynomial function. So u is equal to?
X.
And then dv is equal to? Sine 2x. Okay. So we know that, okay, example, we know that integrate x sine 2x dx. Okay, what is the formula? Can you give me?
U
dv equal to uv minus integrate v. Du. Okay, this is the formula. So u is what? U is equal to x. Why we choose x? Because it's a polynomial function. Okay, so du dx equal to du equal to dx. And then v dv equal to sine 2x, and v equal to negative cos 2x divided by 2. Okay, so by using the formula, negative cos 2x divided by 2 minus integrate v du. The arrow like this. Okay? So, negative cos 2x divided by 2 dx. Then you need to differentiate. Sorry, integrate. So negative 1/2 x cos 2x minus, okay, sorry, plus negative plus x.
Yeah.
Okay, so cos sine 2x So this is the first example by using infinite integrals, because it doesn't have boundaries, the value limit. So the answer need to plus C. X, integrate x to the power of 4, ln x dx. So which one is u? Are you sure? Ln x, because ln, okay. So u is integrate x to the power of 4, ln x dx. So u equal to ln x, du equals to 1/x dx. Okay, so dv x to the power of 4, v equal to x to the power of 5 divided by 5. Okay, so cross. X to the power of 4 ln x dx equal to ln x minus integrate x to the power of 5 times 1/x dx. So in this case, be 3x to the power of 3 ln 3x. So same like A, right? So U equal to ln 3x. What about C? C, if you cannot differentiate between 3 ln x per x squared, just separate the function. 3 ln x, x squared, dx. You just differentiate the separate the function. So, be like this. 1 over x squared. So choose. Where is U is 3, the constant one must put in front. What about B? Exponential and polynomial. Definite integral, we have the limit 3 to 4. So we just integrate and then just substitute the limit. Okay, let's do the equation.
Want the example or exercise?
Yeah. One example. So for this example, U is 1 to x, because log pad, right? So dv equal to x squared. I think you already know how to solve this. So you want me to continue the question or not? Continue. So let u equals to ln to x. Okay. So du dx equal to 1 over 2x times 2. So that's the option. Du equals to 1 over x dx. Okay. What about dv? Dv x squared v. Don't forget to write dx when you write a dv. Okay, so v equals to 2, sorry, x to the power of 3 divided by 3. Okay. So cross, if you don't memorize this formula, you just rewrite the form like this, and then you just cross. Okay. So, u times v, x cubed, ln to x minus integrate, what of the x, okay, then you can ask. Try to solve this question. We have the power, right? So it seems like exponential. Thank you. so one more question I want to solve with you guys, and then after that I will give you a little many games. Let's do together. So you is okay, S square du dx equal to 2x dx, and then dv cos 4x, v equals to sin 4x divided by 4. Okay. Then 1 over 4 x squared sine 4x minus integrate v times du sine 4x divided by 4 times 2x dx. Okay. In this part, we still have two functions, so we need to use integration by part again. Okay, so u equals to 2x, actually it can cancel out 2, 1, so u equal to x. U equal to dx, and then dv equals to sine 4x. The constant we can put outside. Yes, 1 over 2 outside. So it becomes negative cos 4x divided by 4. Then substitute. If let's say you substitute by using this formula, and then you get two functions, what happened? Integrate by part again until you have one function only. Because it's constant, right? So I put outside. It's be like this. 1 over 2 integrate sine 4x x dx. Understand? Just make it simplest form. Okay. So we done answering the question.
You said the substitution method.
Okay. Okay. So one more question. One thing.
So if you need my help, just raise your hand.
You write your answer in the whiteboard. At the whiteboard, which you will answer. Okay. You sign that square. this question, but on the whiteboard.
we have another. But index form. Okay, simplify to index form. Let u x, you get u dx, u v, you get v v 2 over v. Okay. This you can substitute into this formula u dv equal to u v minus integral v du. Okay, after you substitute, you calculate, we get this 2 over 3. We can put outside of integral, we get this answer because this have one function. So we just integrate integrate once. Okay. After that, we get this answer. This is a final answer.
Okay, understand that? Thank you.
So after you list all the formula, I want you to present in front of us about integration by part that we learned today.
We have this formula UdV equal to UV minus integral B du. Okay, this subtopic involves two different functions, which is we have five different functions: LO logarithm, P polynomial, E exponential, P trigonometry, and inverse trigonometry. Okay, from this subtopic we have two different integrals, definite and indefinite. Definite we have limits, which is upper limit minus lower limit. Okay, indefinite we have do not have limits. Okay, from this topic first we can choose U or U and dV. Okay, first basically this side we can let U, and this side we can let as a dV. But any function we can let I as a U. As a inverse function. Okay. That's all from us.
So for indefinite integral, for final answer we need to plus
C.
Yes, plus C. C for what? Constant. Okay. So what about Liana's group? Thank you, Fila and Alia.
Now we will present about the subtopic integral by part. Okay, integral by part. Okay, now it divide by two. We will which is definite integral and indefinite integral. Definite integral, we must know the function must have the boundary. Have boundary that have limit. Upper limit and lower limit. Okay. Indefinite integral don't have limit. Okay. Then integral by part actually have own formula. This is the formula of integral by part, u dv equal to uv minus integrate v du.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, how we to know to use integral by part when we see the function involve two functions?
Two different functions.
Yes, okay. T is, okay, the table is our guide how to identify which function we want to use u or dv.
Yes.
Okay. The function, okay. LO is logarithm, P is the function of polynomial function, E is exponential function, T is trigonometric function and inverse function. Okay, let's say if we have the question involved with logarithm and polynomial function. So, and then we see, okay, this one logarithm function and this is polynomial function. So, u equal to logarithm function and dv is polynomial function, u we will differentiate and dv we will integrate. Okay, that's all from us. Thank you.
Okay, thank you Yana and Pirzana. Okay, so for integration by part, we have learned about the formula, about the what else?
How to choose u
and dv by using
Lopet.
And the table given, the table that you have made. And then also we learned about definite integral and indefinite integral. So basically for indefinite integral, we have we must surplus C at the end of the answer, right?
Yes.
Okay. So I hope that all of you understand what we have learned today, and also yes, and also can answer all the questions involved integration by part. So that's all for today. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So class dismissed. Thank you.